Welcome to lecture number 4 of Effects in HVAC Transmission System. In this lecture, we derive the expression of DC voltage with some ignition delay. Right? So this is a simple gate circuit. The gate control can be used to delay the ignition of the valve. The delay angle is denoted by alpha. And its corresponding time for delay, it is alpha by omega seconds. So these are the different combination. At omega t equal to minus 60 to 0 degree, the valve 1 and valve 2 is conducting. At omega t equal to 0 to 60 degree, the valve 3 and valve 2 is conducting. At omega t equal to 60 to 120 degree, valve 3 and valve 4 is conducting. At omega t equal to 120 to 180 degree, valve 4 and valve 5 is conducting. Similarly, at omega t equal to 180 to 240 degree, valve 6 and valve 5 is conducting. And again, at omega t equal to 240 to 300 degree, valve 6 and valve 1 is conducting. So this is the valve switching sequence with no ignition delay and overlapping. So suppose now if we give the ignition delay, right? See the waveform here. If we provide the delay at alpha equal to 0 degree, right? Delay means we turn on the thyristor after some time interval, okay, time delay. So delay angle, it is denoted by alpha. So now the conduction of EAC phase, right? EAC means valve 1 and valve 2 is conducting after this time alpha, okay. So now if we want to derive the expression of no load DC voltage, so at that time, now your limit of EAC is changing. It is minus 60 plus alpha, right? So average direct voltage, again, the conduction period is 1.5 by 3. The limit is now minus 60 plus alpha. So if we remove the minus sign common, then it is minus of sine 60 minus alpha to alpha EAC d theta. Now, as you know, in previous lecture, the EAC, it is a root 3 m cos theta plus 30 degree. So put the value of EAC. Again, root 3 m, it is a constant. So 3 root 3 em upon pi, it is known as a VDO. Right? So you know that the VDO is equal to 3 root 3 em upon pi. So it is a constant. Now integration of cos, it is a sine, and when we put the upper limit, so we get the VDO cos alpha. That means the DC voltage with delay angle, it is given by VD is equal to 3 root 3 em upon pi cos alpha, or it is also known as VDO cos alpha. So this is a DC voltage with delay angle. Previously we derived the expression of no load DC voltage. In that case, we not given any delay to the system. These are the waveform of a variation of phase displacement between voltage and current. Right here, see the phasor diagram. Right, of phase A with delay angle. Now suppose at initially, right, the both the voltage and current of phase A, it is in phase. So there is no delay angle. After some time, if we provide the alpha equal to 30 degree delay, so at that time, the phasor diagram of your system is, this is your, if you take voltage as a reference, then the current is delay by angle phi. At alpha equal to 60 degree, again, the angle is increasing. At alpha equal to 90 degree, the angle is at a 90 degree, right? So the current is delayed by 90 degree to the voltage of phase A. Similarly, at 120 degree and at 150 degree. So here in this diagram, the EA, it is a phase A line to neutral voltage. IA, it is a phase A line current. EA, it is a voltage phasor. And IA1, it is a fundamental current phasor. Now, how can you calculate the fundamental current, right? So see, the line current or phase current of your system, it is calculated, right, using this equation. So the peak value of your current, fundamental phase component, it is given by ILM, is equal to 1 upon pi by 2. Why pi by 2? Because the total conduction period of your system is pi by 2. And minus pi by 3 to pi by 3, at that time, the ID current of phase A is conducting. And the magnitude of phase A current, it is ID cos X. How this cos X is come? If we take this as a reference, right? So it is a cos term. And therefore we write here the ID cos X. Again, the 2 upon pi ID, this is a constant, and the integration of cos X is sin X, and pi by 3 means 60 degree. So put the limit of upper limit and lower limit, you will get the peak value fundamental frequency component. It is 1.11 ID. Now the RMS value. So the RMS value is equal to the peak value d under root of 2. So this is a peak value, 2 root 3 ID upon pi. If we derive the divide that by root 2, we get IL1, it is the RMS value of fundamental frequency component. It is root 6 upon pi ID, where ID is your DC current. So again, it is a 0.78 ID. So now if we assume the loss in the converter is neglected, and the DC and the AC power must equal to the DC power. So at that time, we write PAC is equal to the PDC. So as you know, what is the value of PAC? It is ELN IL1 cos phi, 3 VI cos phi, right? Remember, you know this equation. By V is a line to neutral voltage, and I is the RMS value of fundamental current. So here it is ELN, line to neutral voltage, and fundamental RMS value of fundamental current, it is denoted by IL1. And the DC power, it is VD ID. So now, if we give the delay, right, so at the time, what is the value of VD? It is VD cos alpha into ID. Right. So we derive the value of IL1, right? So our equation now become 3 ELN IL1 is root 6 upon pi ID cos phi is equal to VDO in terms of ELN. We already derived the expression of VDO in terms of ELN. So VDO is equal to 3 root 6 upon pi ELN ID cos alpha. From this equation, right, the right hand side and left hand side terms are cancelled out. This one. So our equation now become cos phi is equal to cos alpha. If you know the power factor of a fundamental wave, right, you can calculate the delay angle alpha from that. So the converter operates as a device that converts alternating to direct current so that the current ratio is fixed, but the voltage ratio varies with the ignition delay. If we take alpha is equal to 0, so at the time the fundamental current component is in phase with the voltage. And the active power, how can you calculate the active power? The active power, it is calculated by PA is equal to EA IA 1 cos phi. So it's become a positive, right? And the reactive power, it is 0 at alpha equal to 0 degree. Now how can you calculate the reactive power? So the reactive power, it is calculated using the equation QA is equal to EA IA1 sin phi. So alpha equal to 0 or sin alpha, right? Phi means alpha. Okay. So at alpha increases from 0 to 90 degree, EA is decreases and the QA is increases. At alpha increase from 90 to 180, the PA become negative and the QA remains a positive, but the magnitude of QA is decreasing. At alpha equal to 180 degree, the PA is negative. PA is negative maximum value and the QA is 0. So by this way you can supply the reactive power and the active power in the 6 pulse converter. Thank you.